Suggestions, we're going to be diving into none other than, of course, NIO stock. I'm going to be doing a direct side-by-side comparison with Tesla on deliveries, vehicle performance, revenues, and a bunch of other insights that should hopefully give us some clarity into this company. Now, NIO stock is trading up a whopping 1,000% year to date. So if this is something you guys enjoy, consider hitting that like button and let me know in the comment section below what should the next company I review be. But in light of all this, let's jump. Investors alike to NIO, with an only other company comparable being Tesla. So it only makes sense to do a side-by-side comparison on their vehicles, their specs, their finances, their revenues, which will also give us a baseline on how this company is performing. And right now, on the stock side of things, up 1,058%, and it has already gone to the moon and headed to Mars here, folks, with a $57.63 billion market cap. I don't know if it's overvalued. It's definitely trading nowhere near Tesla's market cap, which, I mean, could be undervalued, could be overvalued. That will be pretty perspective based toward the end of this video, but just taking a look, the first thing we have to do, of course, is just take a look at the vehicles and their product lineup. Right now, NIO has three premier vehicles, with the two top ones being the EC6 and the ES8 here, guys. And first thing we're going to do is we're just going to primarily compare it to the Model Y, which is the only comparable mid-class car on Tesla's lineup. And just taking a look first at the EC6, which currently states that it's 615 kilometers of range at a 4.5 seconds from 0 to 100 kilometers an hour. This is pretty intense performance coming out of these batteries here, guys, because even taking a look at their ES8, which is a little less kilometer range, but at 580 is still higher for the size of the SUV compared to this Model Y that only has a 525 kilometer range is pretty impressive. And I don't know if that has relation to the all-wheel drive dual motors that Tesla's pumping out to get the performance, because when we're talking about speed, the Model Y is going to blow it out of the water. Now, there is a lot of other notable details that we could scroll through. The fact that, you know, their cars kind of follow suit with the no door handle. Everything is super flush. The interior is absolutely gorgeous on this thing, and we all know they have that cute little thing on the dash. Almost cartoonily, is that a word? Cartoony, kind of human-like. It's really interesting. They've done a phenomenal job with the design of this vehicle. Now, I don't want to touch base on the features. They are getting into their own, like, little version of self-driving. Just because with the self-driving, and you can quote me if I'm wrong here, guys, I don't believe that they mentioned that they are trying to get down the path of doing exactly what Tesla does. They want to be fully automated. I'm not sure if that's 100% the direction they're going into, is they kind of offer a bunch of driver assist features, which is nice, but that might come down into why the market cap isn't as high flying as Tesla's. As Tesla's obviously moving into multiple different routes, aside from self-driving, you know, they have their solar, they got their battery walls. I don't think that is the kind of market that we're seeing NIO trying to approach, which can equate to that smaller market cap here, folks. But let's just talk about the other numbers that really, really matter when we're trying to value a company like this, and that comes down to these vehicle deliveries. And they just posted this recent article from basically November 2nd this month that NIO delivered 5,055 vehicles going through October, an increase by 100%. And in total for the year of 2020, they hit 31,430 vehicles delivered, which is up 111%. Now, this isn't even closely notable to Tesla. Has been driving out 139,000 vehicles for Q3 of 2020. But we got to remember, these are drastically different companies here, guys. I haven't deep dived down too much into the manufacturing, how they're scaling it, but presuming they're continuing to have 100% rate of regrowth year over year, which has actually been scaling up over time, this is a pretty beautiful sign. But again, 31,000 for the entire year against Tesla in 3 months, Q3 doing 139,000. They got a little ways to go here, but that does not mean they can't be a competitor in the Chinese market. We're gonna have a lot of car competitors coming up here, and it's nice to see that NIO is on the forefront, aggressing this pretty drastically and doing very well. So let's talk about the dead bottom line numbers here, which is where things get rather impressive, because they do have a bunch of different fronts for collecting revenue. You know, they got battery swap out, they got a lot of cool stuff here, guys. But just taking a look at NIO right now for their vehicle sales in Q2, which they are, by the way, going to be releasing their Q3 financial highlights coming up, I do believe, on November 17th. It it's about a week from now, but just taking a look, they did $3.4 billion in vehicle sales with a vehicle margin of 9.7%, which I do believe is the first quarter they actually had a positive margin on actually producing and selling these vehicles. The two biggest concerns that I have here, and this is also a bit of a bonus, is the research and development on expenses, which for both Tesla and NIO were pretty large in the beginning here, but they were currently spending about $77 million for the Q2, which is a decrease of 58.1%. It's nice that they are pulling back on development here, but it would be neat to see what kind of products they have for coming down the pipeline, or are they just going to refine what they have and try and get the margins up and make it that a sustainable business with the three current models of SUVs they have available. But the thing that always bothers me the most when we're talking about Tesla as a brand, guys, they don't spend any money on advertising. And just taking a look at selling, general, and administrative expenses, they were sitting at $132 million, which is nice because it is a decrease of 34.1%. But these are some of the things that you're going to want to look through just to see how they are actually marketing these vehicles, how profitable the marketing is, which now is probably getting a lot better with the attention coming to it. But finally, let's just talk about their bottom basement line numbers, which is where I get more slightly concerned. So just taking a look, they got $14.58 billion in total assets. And this is not accurate here, folks. And this is something that I think a lot of people would be really overlooking because this currency trades in CNY and they got a total liability of $20.85 billion. So if we convert these numbers, starting with the total assets of that $14.5 billion in that currency being yen, converting it over to USD, we're talking about $2.198 billion here against their total liabilities of $3.145 billion, guys. An underlying deficit here of over $1 billion. And this is where things get a little bit sketchier from a stock investing standpoint, because again, having no positive underlying assets against a market capitalization of $57.6 billion, we're talking about years and years into the future. I mean, we're talking here that these things need explosive growth, which again, they do have, but in the comparable notion that they do not have any real self-driving capability that's going to be turned into like a taxi network. I mean, their futures are really reliant on these cars, which comes down as a bit of a hesitation. Considering if we look at Tesla, which a lot of people like to batter, that has a total asset of $34 billion with a total current liability, roughly $26.8 billion. They do have some underlying assets that have creeped up well above the money that they currently have owing. But again, comparing that to a $395 billion market cap, guys, that's pretty scary stuff considering you minus that out. They're not even sitting on $10 billion in underlying assets. So let's just take a look at the revenue ramp up year over year, and just taking a look at Tesla's financials, guys. I mean, this is a growth stock. If they do not continue doing this, we know the stock is going to basically implode. But luckily, even during this pandemic, they did come out in Q3 with record revenues and bottom line earnings of $331 million. And just again, going into NIO here to do a side by side comparison, guys, first looking at the annually, they didn't even start generating any kind of real revenue until about 2018, and then going into 2019 when they actually started ramping it up. But this comes to as a bit of a concern because we're not talking about US dollars here again, which makes this a drastically different story. But just taking a look, guys, they are still operating on a huge deficit month over month over month. They are still posting over $1 billion in losses, but again, we're talking about yen here, we're not talking about US. But until this company is ready to post an EPS on a quarter that's positive without showing, you know, $1 billion in yen losses, I mean, this thing is just going to continue sucking up money, which is a huge concern because the auto market has some of the worst margins on the planet. And the only reason that Tesla's become so attractive is because of the opportunities down the road. Not today, we're obviously speculating on, you know, a taxi network, we're obviously speculating on how popular solar is going to be, but because of those things that have much higher margins and rate of return, including they want to be fully vertically integrated, doing their own insurance and stuff like that, we can see the opportunity for continued growth on their bottom line EPS. But for this company, guys, I mean, it could be a big hindrance if they do not find a way to evolve this or take on some of these other extra features that could allow them to scale faster when we're talking about things like the battery swap outs and a lot of other things in between. But in my honest opinion here, and again, you could have an adverse opinion, I got nothing against it, but I would completely put this in the same class of Tesla right now, is basically being insanely overvalued. Like I said, I would not be buying Tesla at the current levels it sits at. I know people believe in it, it still has good growth potential in the future, but we are now speculating on what might happen in the future, which isn't good for an investor. We don't want to speculate, we want to buy on what we know today. And what we know today is that NIO is still bleeding a super large amount of capital. They're going to be years out from being profitable. They have a huge underlying deficit still. And a lot of this stuff is red flag, red flag, red flag. And even though they are the second flagship next to Tesla in growth, tackling one of the largest markets that need electric vehicles being China, I mean, there is some positive. There is a lot of good things with this company here, guys. But the question is, are they going to continue to steal market share? Are they going to continue to grow? Are they going to find a way to get those margins up? And if so, how much? And again, those margins need to get up through the roof, guys, to justify the $57 billion of market cap they currently sit in. And this is on USDs, by the way. This isn't yet. yen because this is traded on the New York Stock Exchange. So, I mean, we are miles and miles away from where these companies should be sitting in valuation. So if you are buying these things, I would be super, super careful about how aggressive you are in buying them today. Don't be in a rush to get into it. If you already hold it, if you're up huge, just like I did with Tesla, I always recommend taking some profits on stocks that are almost impossible to value. And maybe, yeah, let the rest of it ride into your future, especially if you have, you know, a 10, 20, 30 year time horizon like I do. That's going to put you in the best position. But again, this stock is not for everybody, just like Tesla isn't. But in light of all of this, I would love to know what you guys think in that comment section below. But stay cool, stay awesome, and I can't wait to catch you guys tomorrow.